Took some foliage with it. Guys, Eric, today I've got the Losi 8XT. This is something a little bit different than what you've seen on the channel before. I've never had a kit before, and first of all, huge shout out to Horizon Hobby for sending this out and giving me the opportunity to build a kit. And we're gonna give her some, you know, some bashing, see what she can handle, and then also some racetrack time too. I've definitely got some plans for that for the future. But this truck, I mean, was just legendary as far as the build goes. Everything was so butter smooth. Everything went together awesome. The instructions were really easy. Everything came in separate bags. It was a lot of fun. I've never built a kit before, so it was definitely a very nice experience. Here's a quick shot of the box. You know, everything comes with it, you know, but the tires, electronics, and stuff like that. It does come with the body. You can build this either in electric or nitro. Everything is included for either setup that you would need. But if you go nitro, of course, you're going to need your engine and all that jazz. But real quick, here's a shot of the truck and the body. This is the body that comes with it. I mean, it's a killer, nice, truggy body. It's super, super thick. And I went ahead and did it's like a metallic orange. I started out with a clear metallic, and then hit it with the orange, and then backed it with yellow, just to kind of get that. You probably can't see it in the camera, but in the sun, it's got kind of a yellowish tint to it, kind of a gold with the sparkles. It's pretty darn cool. So pretty happy how that turned out. And here's a shot of the truck. Everything, I mean, the suspension on this baby is butter smooth. I did change a couple things for a bashing setup, but I didn't go too astray, because I do plan on racing this truck, hitting up the racetrack with it. I built it basically, you know, from manual spec. The only thing I did change is I went up to from 12.5 to 100,000 in the center diff, and I did a 45 weight in the rear shocks. I believe the stock standard was 32 weight, because I felt the back was a little too springy for bashing. So now everything is just butter smooth on it. As far as the motor goes, I did drop in a Hobby Star 4076 2000 KV paired with a Max 8 ESC. And I got an 18 tooth pinion. I will be experimenting with the pinions. I believe an 18 tooth is a good place to start. I did go out and do some street bashing and yard bashing the other day, just to kind of give this truck a lowdown, just get a feel for it. And everything stayed pretty cool. And she was still fast. I did switch out the servo arm right here to a nice aluminum one from the plastic one that comes with it. It does come with an adapter, a gear that goes inside here to hook up to whatever size servo or whatever tooth servo that you have, which is pretty cool. But I just had this sitting around, so I decided to go ahead and upgrade that. And also upgraded the top plate to an aluminum top plate and front brace. Because here's the stock one right here, you know, which is plastic. I mean, it's a very nice design. It should definitely hold up. But I figure aluminum, you know, would definitely be the way to go for bashing. For racing, you probably want the plastic, because you do want a little bit of flex, and you want the truck to be as light as possible. I'm still running the stock plastic brace. I can't find one right now, but Mitch from M2C Racing, I'm already working with him to go ahead and start working on some bracing, and possibly in the future, you know, a chassis and tires for it as well, you know, for guys that really want to bash it hard. But I'm trying to keep it light, keep it so I can race it as well. I mean, but everything on this truck is just absolutely beautiful. The machine, everything is 7075 aluminum, tires, chassis. I mean, it's very nice machining work. And the diffs went together just butter smooth. I mean, there's no play in anything. It's just such a nice truck. The truck is super lightweight compared to like a beefed up Arma. So that's definitely something I'm going to have to get used to with as far as the throttle finger goes. You know, you don't want to overcorrect, but as far as the handling of it, I mean, it handles like it's on rails. It's a complete different scenario from what I'm used to. It's just a very nice truck all the way around. I mean, it's got some, it's got lots of upgrades and updates on it compared to, you know, some of the older model kits. Real quick, I'm going to just kind of read off a couple of things here that I found as far as some of the updates on it. But again, it's got nitro and electric parts are included. Improved suspension geometry, flex tuned suspension arms. It's got a wider 3mm chassis, a larger pinion bearing. Cab forward style body, chassis side guards, large footprint nitro engine mount, one piece electric motor mount, adjustable caster blocks. That's really cool to really dial the truck in. Bleeder shock caps, balanced chassis, Ackerman adjustable drag link steering rack, a machined aluminum shock towers. It's got better diff access. It's got an awesome sway bar system, equalized drive line, updated radio tray. optimized shocks, ball bearing throttle and brake actuator. So I won't waffle on too much. I just wanted to kind of go over a few things that I found there, because I'm not really familiar with the Losi trucks and all that, so I don't know what all the changes were. So that was kind of nice to find that. Here's a quick shot of the manual. Everything in here was super easy to follow. It had its own bags, for every part. It starts with the diffs and it moves on to the shocks, and just everything just goes together so smooth. And as you get towards the back, where you would get, to your nitro motor and stuff, everything is marked with an N is for nitro, and anything, with an E beside it is for electric. So you don't get confused. There's an E here, and then this is, for your nitro, so you don't get confused about, what instructions you're looking at, which is really, really cool. And real quick, right here on the center diff, I did do a modification. I added in a piece of Lexan. I screwed that down basically to house this body support that I put in here. It's like just a few pieces of some stiff foam that I attached in with some Gorilla Tape. That way it sets on here and gives it a nice support. I am pairing it up to this radio link that they sent out a while back. I did a review with the Infraction on it. It's a killer radio. Again, 400 meter range, and it's got loads of options in here to choose from. So I paired this up with that, which is also cool because the steering wheel matches the body. So it's a perfect match. But anyway, all right, guys, I'm gonna give this thing a rip. I am running Katars on it, Italian Katars, vented. This is one of my favorite tires because the Arm Italian is probably my favorite RC of all. Most of you guys know that. So I was lucky to find a new fresh set of Katars at my local hobby shop because they're really hard to find online right now. So I lucked out with that, so we're going to give her a rip, and let's see what's up. Guys, this thing is crazy. It's so lightweight. Super agile. Oh, a little bit on the nose there. Like I said, she's real touchy being so lightweight. A little Losi that could. Took some foliage with it.